Good morning. My name is Chief Jamie Sullivan with the Hampton Police Department. I'll start off and just ask the other folks that are with us here to step up and identify themselves, and then we'll have a brief statement for you as well.
Chris Silver, I'm the Hampton Fire Chief.
Good morning. I'm Chief Dave Andreessen. I'm the officer in charge of the Coast Guard Station in Portsmouth Harbor.
Good morning. I'm Jim Donahue, Chief of Hampton Beach Patrol.
As you all know, last night at approximately 7:50, we received an emergency call for individuals having distress in the waters off of Hampton Beach. Hampton Police and Fire responded to that, and upon investigation determined that there was a group that was having some difficulty in the water. Upon investigation, it was determined that there were two individuals who had distress in the water. One of them was a 12-year-old girl who we are now identifying as Naylene Encarnacion. We'll spell the last name for you, E-N-C-A-R-N-A-C-I-O-N, of Lawrence, Massachusetts. She was in the water with a group. Naylene, spelled N-A-E-L-I-N. She was in the water with her 20-year-old brother and some other individuals that were up here visiting the beach. She began to have difficulty in the water. Her brother attempted to assist her and subsequently began to have difficulties himself. He was assisted out of the water by bystanders, and our officials arrived on scene, began to identify the area where the child had gone missing in the water. The Hampton Beach lifeguards, who were off duty at the time, returned and began a search of the water. Hampton Fire Rescue launched their boats and searched as well. After approximately an hour, the lifeguards The lifeguards were forced to discontinue the search due to safety reasons as darkness fell. We were joined in the search by the Coast Guard. Coast Guard assets were on station all last evening, continuing the search this morning. This morning we're going to continue searching. Joining us today will be the New Hampshire Fish and Game Dive Team and the Marine Patrol, bringing additional equipment to assist in the search. At this point in time, I'll turn it over to any questions you may have of the individuals with me.
Chief, where are you going to send in the divers? Have we heard from the Coast Guard that maybe the tide was taking a little bit north? Where are you kind of concentrating the search?
We'll coordinate with those folks when they come in. We'll give them the information, and their expertise will determine the best place to begin the search.
Is this a recovery at this point, or is this still a search?
We're continuing to search at this point in time.
So you believe that she's still alive? I mean, the survivability out there is... 7 hours.
Yeah, our focus right now is on searching and locating her. That's where our focus is.
Have you been able to identify if there were any repairs or unusual
tide? I'll ask Chief Donahue to speak to the current conditions.
Pardon me, what was that?
Have you been able to identify if there were specific rip currents or if there was something unusual going on?
No, I wasn't on scene at the time, but that area is typically not one of our areas where we encounter rips. It's relatively safe in that section of the beach.
Can you talk about the conditions today, how the search is going, easy, hard?
We'll have Chief Anderson to talk about the Coast Guard and the search aspect.
Okay, what was your question?
Just the conditions out there.
The conditions are ideal right now. We have good visibility. The sea conditions are calm, and we have sunny weather, so the conditions are very, very good right now.
What about the resources that you're bringing to bear for today's search? We heard about the divers are in standby or out. What sort of people do you have out there?
We have a boat crew, Coast Guard boat crew from the Portsmouth Harbor Coast Guard Station. We also have New Hampshire Marine Patrol boat that's out of Newcastle that's on station, and we're going to have the fish and game boat out here shortly.
Why no helicopter?
At this point, the helicopter, we used the helicopter last night, and we used a fixed-wing aircraft this morning. At this point, we have enough assets on the water, and we have good visibility, and we have daylight, so the best asset to use is surface assets.
So if yesterday, if it's an area that's relatively safe, there are no reports of your kind, can you give us some sense of what you think might have happened?
I can't speak to that, unfortunately.
I don't know, if you're able to maybe talk with that, John?
Well, the water is extremely cold. You're talking 50 to 53 degrees. A strong individual will feel the effects of that after about 15 or 20 minutes. It can affect your ability to swim, to keep yourself afloat. The surf was a little large, but again, we didn't have any problems during the day with any rips in that area.
Chief, what about the family? Can you tell us anything about how they're coping?
Well, as you imagine, they're very distressed. We were with the family who were here, the brother, last evening till late in the evening. We've been in contact with the mother down in Lawrence. Coast Guard as well has been in touch with her. As you imagine, extremely distressed.
Did they give you a sense of why they went out so late? A lot of people in the water at that time?
No. It was a warm evening yesterday, very humid, and there were a number of people down at the water at that point in time. I didn't find it unusual.
Did you know how to swim? Had you been out during the day? Can you sort of explain the scenario? Were they too far out, or is that normal? Be out that distance?
I can't answer that specifically. With regard to her swimming, we were described, it was described to us that she had some ability to swim. That was the description to us.
And do you have any suggestions? I mean, obviously we have the warm weather between now and July 4th when all the lifeguards, I mean, do you have any suggestions as people out here today? Stay out of the water, be careful. How do you avoid a tragedy?
Well, I'll ask Chief Donahue to speak to water safety issues.
Number one.
Number
one, know your limitations. I mean, if you're a non-swimmer or a poor swimmer, you shouldn't go in the ocean when lifeguards are not on duty. Right now, my guard crew is reforming it. We will be on weekends, and we'll be full-time at Hampton Beach from June 11th on. But bottom line is, know your limitations. Never swim in the ocean without lifeguards on duty. It changes. It can change in minutes.
Chief Anderson,
if I could just touch on what he said. Another thing to be aware of, it was a pretty cold spring, so the ocean temperature hasn't had an opportunity to warm up to what it normally is this time of year, so it's still in the very low 50s. So, you know, it might be 85, 90 degrees on the beach. The water is very cold. Hypothermia could still set in. When you're in that cold water, even though it is 90 degree air temperature.
And I heard from some local fishermen that wanted to help in the search. Would that help or hurt your efforts?
Good Samaritans are always welcome to come and assist us. And if they are in the area and they want to help us out, they should get in touch with the Coast Guard boat that is on scene and speak with them.
You said that the brother tried to assist her or save her. Is there anything you can relay that he said about this?
He didn't say very much when we spoke to him. He was, you know, as you can tell, he was exhausted. He was pretty shooken up, and it was late at night.
Did the brother's name? And the person who rescued him, do you have his name as well?
The brother's name is Walter, and I'll spell his last name, M-A-L. D-O-N-A-D-O, Maldonado. And the individuals who assisted him out of the water was a... I just want to confirm the name. A Richard White. Richard White.
Or?
I believe he's from the local area, yes.
From Hampton Beach?
I don't want to speak. I don't have his address on the report, but I believe he's a local person.
And where's Maldonado from? Is he from Lawrence as well?
That's correct.
Of the girl? Of the girl.
Yes.
He said Naylene.
Spell her name. First name, N-A-E-L-I-N. Last name, E-N-C-A-R-N-A-C-I-O-N.
And Chief, it's my understanding that she was here with her older brother and another sister and some friends. Is that correct?
There were a group of five in total that were here together for the day. Yes.
Can you speak to about how far out they were?
I'll ask Chief Silva if he can speak to that.
Chief Donner, you should speak better on the distance from shore.
The waves, when I came on scene, which was a little after 8 o'clock, were approximately 40 to 50 yards from the shoreline.
Was there a delay in the time that she became distressed out there and the time that you were able to get out to search for her, help her, your lifeguards, because you said there were no lifeguards out there. They left at 5:30. This was an hour and a half later. And what delay did that have upon rescuing her?
There's no answering that question, really. There was a delay. I mean, I have a certain number of guards that are on call, but there is a time delay from where they're at the time to get on scene. But the response was good. We had 10 lifeguards in the water, paired up in twos. But there was a delay, naturally.
Did the cold water limit the amount of time they could spend in there?
They were outfitted with wetsuits, full wetsuits. They could stay as long as... They weren't affected by the cold water, but it became more or less futile when darkness set in, the water being dark and in very poor visibility.
So, Jim, are you saying that until June 11th, stay out of the water? What's the simplest way you can explain your message?
It's a call that's tough because as a lifeguard, you would like to say, please stay out of the water. But there are individuals that are better swimmers than others. There are non-swimmers. If you're a non-swimmer or a poor swimmer, you have no business being in the water beyond, say, your knees or your waist.
So, Chief, if you could maybe talk about the day. So these divers and Fish and Game are coming in. Do you plan to search for the entire day? Do you presume that she's still out there and that she can be rescued?
Well, we certainly will use whatever assets are at our disposal to continue the search. As the day progresses, based on information we developed during the search, we'll reassess what's the most effective use of those assets and the time frame. And we'll try and keep you folks updated as that progresses during the day. Any other questions?
I assume this is sort of difficult for you guys, the unofficial start to summer and actually your first tragedy of the season.
Our real focus right now is on finding this young lady. That's what our focus is on. If there's no other questions, thank you very much.
Thank you, Chief.